What's up, guys and gals? It's me, your old buddy, Mr. Moose, back with another edition of American Truck Simulator. And we continue our holiday series of the Grand Gift Delivery. And this is going to be our sixth delivery today that we're going to be making. Now, we've moved just over from Sierra Vista to Nogales. There weren't any contracts in Sierra Vista, so I hauled a quick load over to Nogales, hoping that would reset everything. And sure enough, I've got a load over there going to Oxnard. Up in California. So that is going to be the run that we make today. Hope you guys enjoy it. Hope you guys had a wonderful Christmas. Let's get the haul in a little load. Now, we just topped off our tanks here at the gas station. So let's just get fired back up. The load's right across the street at the FedEx distributor. So let's get going. It is unfortunately going to be another evening trip, rolling out around 5 o'clock in the afternoon. But again, you take the trips when you can get the trips and go from there. So I do want to apologize to you guys that didn't have a ATS out for you yesterday on the 26th, I guess it was. I had every intentions of getting one out for you, but I've had some computer issues over the last couple of days that I've really had to deal with, and it's been quite frustrating. It seems like if it can break, it will, and it has for me. So I've had to deal with a couple little little setbacks and have had to kind of get a little innovative even to be able to do these videos, because a couple of things went out on me. My headphones died. I had a really nice wireless pair of headphones that I love to death, and they just completely went out. They wouldn't recharge anymore, and that's sort of like a reoccurring theme for me the last couple of days. Not only did I have that happen with the headphones, I had the same thing happen with the transmitter device that I use for Track IR. I purchased last year, most of y'all know, a product called Track Hat Clip Pro. And I was pretty happy with it. Now, they made some representations about the product that I think are a little exaggerated, especially the battery life as far as how long you can hold a charge on the battery. But other than that, I've pretty much been happy with it. So there's the load we're going to be hauling. Let's go ahead and do our little tug test, make sure everything's good. Yep. All right, and we'll get rolling out of here. Yeah, I mean, they claim like on a battery charge you can get like 12 hours of gameplay, and I've never seen that. Never once. Even when the was brand new, never ever did I get 12 hours out of it. The most I think was like 5.5. You know, I'd let it fully charge up, and then I'd start driving ETS one night, and by about the 5.5 hour mark, I was having to plug it back in because the battery was dying, and the camera was starting to stick. So, but it's still been a pretty good product. I've liked it. I've enjoyed it. And but yeah, it just stop charging. Won't take a charge at all anymore. And you know, of course, it's out of warranty, so I'm out of luck on that, and it's pretty expensive. I don't know that I'll buy another one, just because it has to come from the UK, and so with the exchange rates and everything, I kind of get raped on that one. So I think I might be looking for other alternatives. Or I might tear this one apart and see if I can figure out why it isn't charging anymore. But yeah. So those couple of things happened. So I realized real quick yesterday too. I can't drive ATS anymore without my my Track IR. I have become so dependent on it and so comfortable with driving with it, that I just can't, just silly. Come on, AI, just drive like human beings do. And human beings don't sit there on the side of the road and hold up a city block full of traffic like that. And if they do, they're just stupid. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. See, I mean, there's just more of the stupidity of this game. I'm sitting here expecting that car, watching it in my mirror, to come on and just pull right on by me, so I start to veer out a little bit, and the retard slams the brakes on. Come on, SES, fix the AI. They have to be predictable. You have to be able to say, a car is driving 60 miles an hour on the interstate. They are not going to brake check like that and let a car, you know. Oh, yeah. Let me just go ahead and stop so that truck coming up the off-ramp can get on. And at the same time, I need to be able to look at that car and go, that car's going 60 miles an hour. As it comes on up next to me, I should be able to maintain the speed that I'm at, feather off my gas just a little bit, let them pass and get over into the lane. That's how we real people drive. But I understand you have to, you know, create pockets for people who can't drive. But, geez, a little predictability there. Other than I can predict that it's going to do the stupidest thing ever. Way to ruin my drive. Just start me off right behind the eight ball. Alright, well, all these drives are through the world of trucks, so that means that we are governed at 65. So we might as well gear up and set the cruise control and just enjoy the drive, you know. We'll periodically have to do some downshifting in order to maintain speed, but for the most part, we're going to be on the cruise control running down the interstate. So anyways, crazy times. How was your Christmas? I hope you had a wonderful one with you and your family. Ours, little interesting, little deviation from the norm, as the number one member of the family came up with some issues. We, our eldest dog had a little problem on Christmas Eve. We believe now she had a stroke. And, which was absolutely crazy because nobody really realized anything happened until we sat down for dinner. She was up walking around doing all kinds of stuff and was greeting people when they came in. And then we sat down for dinner and realized she wasn't underneath the table trying to beg for food, right? And you're like, something's wrong, somebody's missing here, you know? And got to looking around, she was laying over in her bed, just laying there, you know? And got to checking on her a little bit. And you could tell she just didn't feel good. And, you know, so a little bit of concern. Everybody started worrying about the dog. And then later as the evening progressed, I realized that she wasn't using her front legs at all. And so the vet got called and we had to deal with that. And everybody sat around most of the night worrying about the dog. And it's so funny because, you know, you realize how special they are and how much a part of your life they are. When everybody was kind of like, well, Christmas won't be the same without her because she has the uncanny ability to unwrap presents. And we've always just, I take more joy out of watching her unwrap presents than getting a present of any sort. And everybody tends to buy the dogs a whole lot of gifts so that the dogs can sit and unwrap presents all morning long. And even when we unwrap presents, we tend to let the dog come over and help us unwrap the present. And just realizing that she wasn't going to be a part of the holiday festivities sort of kind of put everybody in a downer. So we had that to deal with. And then, of course, Christmas Day dealt with that all day. Getting the vet over to take a look at her and spend a little bit of time figuring out what was wrong with her. Didn't know if she had ruptured a disc in her neck or, because my other dog had that happen. He ruptured a disc in his neck and we had to have surgery done. So, you know, you're sitting there wondering, well, okay, if she ruptured a disc in her neck, are we going to have to pack a bag and get out of town quick? Because the closest facility that does the surgery to us is in Birmingham. Birmingham or LSU, one of the two, would be where we would have had to have gone. And which we've gone to Birmingham for the little dog, but for her, so we're just kind of figuring out what we were going to have done and where we were at. And one thing led to another. We didn't even have Christmas as a family until late in the evening. I had just told y'all the day before that, you know, Christmas usually starts wee early in the morning, and that just didn't happen. So most of Christmas Day was spent worrying about the old puppy. And so, but anyway, she spent spent a couple of days over at the vet, and she's back home now, but not doing real well. The vet believes she had a stroke, and basically said we had 72 hours to evaluate her and see what was going on, and see how much of a recovery she would make, and I don't know. Tough, man. Tough times. You don't realize how much you love those little dogs. So anyways, that's what's been going on in my world. Just to bring you guys up to speed. But I finally figured out a workaround for my track IR last night. Since I didn't have the little transmitter, I had to resort back to the old track IR hat reflectors. And the way I had my system set up, it didn't like using that. So I had to reconfigure some things and reposition the camera that picks up the reflectors. I had to move it much closer to where I sit when I game. Had to get all that organized and reroute some cables and things of that nature. I'm back using a really old pair of Sony MDR-V6 headphones for gaming now, and getting used to having that cable permanently attached to the headphones. That takes a lot of getting used to after playing wireless for so long. But all the trials and tribulations that Moose has to go through to get a video done. And then the game's just not cooperating with me either. The amount of time I've spent trying to get a World of Trucks contract to haul gifts, I'm not even... I don't get it. Why you have to spend so much time trying to find one. And you know, and other people just... Man, it was bang, 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 bang. They got their contracts and they got done with it. And congrats to those folks who didn't have to spend 30 minutes refreshing the World of Trucks account to try to get a job to get out of town, or to, you know, drive to other cities to try and find an account. I've talked with a lot of people, and they all were the same thing. Where do I find my next load? I drove to this city and I checked my account and I don't have one. Well, sleep and refresh. That doesn't work. Drive to a different city. Nobody wants to hear that when they're trying to power through 10 loads. My unfortunate situation was I got to Sierra Vista, and then I got over to Nogales, figuring, well, I'll just roll over there because there's a FedEx there and I should be able to take a job out of there, which is, I think FedEx is saved goods in the game. So anyways, I drove over there and I got there and it had 3 gift jobs, all of which were going to, you guessed it, Sierra Vista. And that doesn't do you any good since you have to go to 10 different destinations. So I had to reset. Don't you dare do it. Oh man. There are times I wish I had a big, huge cattle catcher on the front of this and angled slightly to the right. You just Olay that truck right out of the road. Would be nice. You just Mad Max it. Is that a hot air balloon? I guess it is. I'm sure that's probably been in the game, and just, I've probably driven by it several times and just not noticed it. Pretty interesting. Whoops. I'm absolutely the worst at third person driving. Me and Drone Cam just don't get along. Anyways, we'll make this run, knock it out. That'll be 6. Then I'll probably do a couple more runs in Euro Truck. And then we'll wrap it up here in ATS again. And we'll get our dragon skin. Somebody completed it the other day and posted a couple of pictures. I think Lurch has done it and completed it because he was showing a steering wheel shot. Now, I think a few of the guys have done it and completed. My problem is I just can't sit down and run through 10 jobs one after another. Bang, 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 bang. And it's not that I can't do it. It's just, wanting to make content for the channel, wanting to record the videos for you guys and share them. It's sort of hard with everything that I've got going on with trying to get things done and get the videos processed and get them uploaded and everything else like that. Finding a little bit of time to sit down and record 10 videos has been interesting. Interesting to say the least. You know, even now it's 6 o'clock in the morning when I'm recording this. But hopefully today, if Hemi doesn't distract me with too much arc, I will I'll get a couple more videos recorded for you guys and get things going. And hopefully I'm going to try to do a live stream tonight. Just, I just wasn't in the mood last night after everything that had gone on, dealing with the vet and dealing with the dog, and kind of in a funk, you know, when you realize that these may be the last few days that you have with your puppy dog, you know. So just kind of wasn't in the mood to go do that. And of course, every 5 minutes, somebody wanted to talk to me about the dog and give me advice on what they thought they should do. At the end of the day, it all comes down to quality of life, right? Hopefully, though, I've said a whole lot of prayers, and hopefully the old guy upstairs listening and will give me the answer that I need. It may not be the answer that I want, but it will be the answer that I need. Right? Isn't that the way it works? You can say your prayers and you can ask for something. At the end, what you get may not be what you want, but it may be what you need. Most certainly is what you need. So she might recover. She might get a full recovery and everything will be hunky-dory and we can cherish the time we have with her. But she is getting up there. She's 13 years old. So, and for a dachshund, that's a lot of years. So, without having any kind of major back problems. But if it's her time, it's her time, you know? And I share that with you guys not to get you down, just to let you know what's going on in my world, you know. And while I see, you know, while I know a lot of people want to say, well, you know, sorry, blah, 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 blah. I look at the positive in everything, you know. Had a wonderful dog for all these years. And so if it's her time, it's her time. All right. Well, where are we at? We are about 7 hours out, 279 miles to go. We're sitting here in a horrible California speed zone now, which I have the hardest time staying at 55. I just can't stand it. It feels like you're just crawling through here. I mean, I hate California. I'll tell you this. When this game expands and a couple of more states come out, I'm never coming through California again. Now, when this map moves east, or the game moves east, and we get to go through, you know, Colorado, Utah, Wyoming. When those states start coming in, see you, California. I'm done with you. You and your 55 mile an hour speed zones. Yep. If Oregon and Washington are next, I drive a whole lot of time up there. Which those drives ought to be pretty fun. I'm really looking forward to the Northern Corridor. I'm really looking forward to, and hopefully there's some, you know, some Canada stuff in the works soon. But I'm really looking forward to the Northern Corridor, running across I-80, up through Wyoming, that kind of area. I can't wait for that stuff to get implemented in the game. That'll be a lot of fun, because that's where, if they do it right and with the rescale and everything, you're going to have a lot of climbs that you got to do. Those will be great. Really looking forward to I-80 around Laramie. That stretch between Laramie and Cheyenne. Woohoo! Yep. Get ready for no scenery, but man, it'll be a fun drive. We used to drive through there when I was younger. And it's so funny, you could leave Cheyenne, and when the radio station started tuning out a little bit on your, in your radio, when it started getting a little fuzzy and starting to tune out, you could hit the seek button on it so it would roll through the channels and find the strongest signal and lock onto it. You could hit that button and it would roll and roll and roll, and it would sit there and do that until you got to Laramie. Because there ain't nothing up there. But drive through there in the winter time when it's, after it's snowed a little bit, absolutely gorgeous. But at the same time, you're driving through and you've got all the wind drifts, or all the, I forget what they're called. They're all up down the side of the road, and they look like a set of bleachers that have been laid on their side. And they prevent the blowing snow from going across the interstate. And, just, you go through there during the winter and all that snow's built up and just absolutely gorgeous, but the weather can turn on you in a heartbeat. And, those roads can get sloppy nasty. Hopefully SES does something in the area of a fall run or an early winter run through there, and doesn't, have it in the middle of the summer. That would be kind of not fun. Kind of a waste. 4 hours and 22 minutes until our next dry or sleep period, so we're going to pass up this rest stop. And just keep on driving. We got plenty of fuel, so I don't have to worry about that. And I should go ahead and qualify my remarks and say that, because I'm sure I've already sparked a conversation, I have no idea what the next state's going to be or the next map adjustment will be for this game. A lot of people speculate that it's New Mexico. Others speculate that it's Colorado or possibly Washington and Oregon. I don't know. And to be honest with you, I really don't care. I'll just take whatever they give us. I just hope that we get, quite a bit rolling out, bang, 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 next year. Hopefully they're excited to try to make some money off of all of us, and they'll bang, bang, bang some content out, because I would really like to get some more maps and more coverage into the game. It would be really nice, and I don't mind spending the money on it. It keeps the game fresh. So hopefully that will be in our near future. I just realized we haven't done the number 8 challenge. Oh yeah. Here we go. Let's keep that truck in on the interstate. Oh, whoa. Got a little squirrely there. Rolling along, rolling along. Nothing to see here. Just a guy driving on drone cam. Actually, this isn't drone cam. This is like city cams, city traffic cams. Well, I'm a little out there. I get flagged by now. Somebody be like, man, that guy's drunk. Let's go back in cab. We don't want to wreck and ruin somebody's Christmas present. Have to ponder the question though, since I'm doing this job on the 27th of December, right? Am I hauling presents for Santa or am I hauling returns? Yeah, I'd like to bring this back. This huge honking box that's on the back of this here trailer. I took this out to Johnny Rich Kid and he didn't want it. Because he had a silver spoon stuck so far down his throat that he didn't want it. So but yeah, so are we hauling late gift presents? Oh, sorry, kids. I know one Christmas morning you woke up and you thought the world forgot you. But no, this load was just sitting at the dock and I had to go get it. Sorry to disappoint you on Christmas Day, but here we go. Better late than never. Oh, time flies in this game. 3 hours and 14 minutes left in our little drive. Or until we get to our destination. Now, what does that mean for sleep time? 3 hours and 2 minutes. Ooh, is it possible that we get there in one sleep cycle? Doubtful. But, yeah, we'll have to stop somewhere before we make the delivery, but that's all right. It takes all, you know, I always think, oh, man, I hate to have to stop and sleep when I'm recording these videos, but I mean, what does it take? 15 seconds? 20 seconds? I mean, it's not like I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to sleep. I'll see you guys tomorrow in the next video. All right, looks like we're getting off up here. Oh, let's get off of the old, oh, really, car? Really? You didn't see that turn indicator? And neither did this guy see the turn indicator. The right turn indicator on the whole time. Just didn't think I did. Oh, is this that bypass? Should have planned better. I gotta get back into the habit of looking at the route advisor before I take a run and replan my route. I could have stayed on the highway the entire time and not had to come through this little side street. But since the game calculates the shortest distance for you, it doesn't take into consideration that the other way was faster. Yeah, I could have stayed on the interstate the whole time instead of being diverted through here. All right, whoa, up until we get down here and get back on the interstate. Yeah, and the thing is I know to do that from ETS. I mean, in ETS, you always check your route advisor to make sure that you're going on a route that is the best for you, you know? If you want to drive highway the whole time, then you definitely want to plot your route, because it's going to take you on some routes that you might not want to run. Dude, starting to yawn on me. We should probably take a glance at the route advisor here in just a few and see what we got going on, but it looks like we're getting right back off the highway up here. No, we're getting on the bypass. Okay. Getting on the old 101. Why this is 40 miles an hour, I have no idea. And of course, there's a cop right behind me. This is ridiculous. This is an interstate. 40 miles an hour. Give me a break. Now we're starting to get in the red. So definitely let's look at our route. See what we got. Alright, so we got a place we can sleep right here. So we'll take off to this little rest area here. We'll rest. Which is cool, because this is one of those add-in rest areas that they put in during the rescale. So it'll be nice to use it. We'll sleep. That'll get us into the daylight hours, which would be nice to make a daylight delivery for a change. Uh-oh. Is the rest area full? No, I'm just kidding. Oh, did I just screw up here? Really? You gotta pull in there? Oh, man. Didn't see that as an issue. Okay, let's see if we can back up here a little bit. Oops. A little out of whack on that. This isn't good. Yeah, first time pulling in here. I didn't realize you actually had to pull in here and then make an abrupt 90-degree turn to get into here. That doesn't seem legit. This seems like a really bad idea now. Yep. All right, we'll pull in here. and see if we can get park. Now I know why dude slept out there. Oh, and it's not even a pull through. Come on, guys. Ugh. What are they thinking when they do this stuff? Have you been to the US? Really? This is just a nightmare here. Alright, note to self, never ever pull into one of these again. Yeah, no, I just ditched these. I mean, this is just ridiculous. This is a sucker deal. It's a trap. That's what it is. Yeah, this was put in as a way to trap you. You think, oh, well, it's great. They added in a rest area. Wrong. Yeah, this was put in for somebody to have a good laugh over. Hey, we'll put in a rest area there and they'll lose their mind trying to get in and out of it. Now I'm just about going to pinch up on that wall. Oh, just barely got out of there. I'm sorry. That's just worthless. I don't know, how do y'all feel about that one? I'm not real happy about it. Come on. Shift gears. Wow. Yeah, that's one of those rest areas I'll never be driving into again. Well, here's Oxnard. I don't even know where we're going to. Let's look. We're going to the Walmart. Which apparently we're not going to the one in Oxnard. As we can see it right there on our screen, we're going to the one on the other end of Oxnard. But we're in the home stretch. We can see it on the route advisor. So we can know where we're going now. Come on, vehicles. Oh, something doesn't look right here. Oh, man. Interesting little run there. It was going good until we got up on the 101, and then it all went away when we decided to take a little nap. Well, actually, it's been doomed from the beginning. But yeah, what did we get since we got on the 101? We got a speeding ticket. We got a rest area that is a joke. We ran in, you know, hit a truck while we were in that rest area. Yeah, not my finest moment of this particular run. Happens though, huh? Alright, right turn lane. Well, maybe I need to stay in this lane. Because it looks like we are making a right turn up here. Cash for cars. The world is yours. Well, I just hosed this run. This did not look like a Walmart shopping thing. It looked like we were going much further up before we made a turn. It looks like we're gonna get in okay. I was worried I was gonna hit that building. Alright, welcome to the Walmart, everybody. Or what, you know, it's really the Walbert, but. Alright, so here is our load in here with the milk crates all the way up against it. Alright, let's get this guy in here and get done. Get Santa's little job done. And we'll make somebody happy, namely me, because I will have job number 6 done, and that'll be nice to know. Alright, start cutting it around. Then we'll hard to the left. Alright, let's straighten it up a little bit. Go. Keep bringing her back. And we'll have this one delivered. Make sure we're clear on this side. We are. All is good. There we go. Wrap it around and that'll work. We're a little crooked. What do you say we straighten it up just a wee bit? There we go. That should be nice and straight. Boom! Let's take a look at what we did. And nice. I'll take that one. That's just about perfect, I would say. Almost equal spacing on each side. I like that. Alright, let's get our picture for the old thumbnail. Screenshot. And set her up like a soul. Take that shot. Here we go. And we actually have a little sunlight on the picture this time, which is kind of nice. All right, let's trailer it and get paid. See what kind of penalties we paid for smacking the truck and all that good stuff. Oh, excellent. All right, job complete. And that is number 6, 4 to go, and we will continue on. Like I said, I'll probably jump over and do a couple of Euro truck episodes, and we'll continue to do those. I'd like to do them through France with the DLC, but we'll jump in there and we'll do a couple of Euro trucks, and then we'll come back and we'll wrap everything up with ATS, and we'll do a couple more ATS jobs. So anyways, thanks for watching today, guys. I hope I didn't depress you too much with sharing my little story with you. But, you know, again, I'm trying to just be, you know, open with you, let you know what's going on in my world. And if you did like the video, please go ahead and smack that like button for me. It helps me out tremendously. Go ahead and feel free to share the video with your friends if you'd like. And, of course, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done already. I do new videos each and every day for you guys. So come on back tomorrow for another one, or try to join me for the live stream. Again, we'll try to do one tonight around 6 o'clock, unless something goes down that I'm not available. I should be able to do one tonight. So thanks for watching, guys. As always, I do appreciate it. We I will say it again, we've just recently hit 24,000 and I appreciate that so much. I can't tell you guys how awesome that is, that you guys enjoy the channel and that you keep coming back, and I appreciate it. And if you guys keep coming back, I'll keep making videos, and we'll just kind of grow it together. All right, thanks for watching. Have yourself a wonderful day. May God bless you and your family. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.